He also serves as Distinguished Visiting Professor of Church History at Midwestern Baptist Theological Seminary. Hey, I'm a student there. I'm a doctorate student at Midwestern Baptist Theological Seminary, and I think I should try and meet this gentleman. So if you like history, this book is for you. If you like American history, this book is really for you. And if you like American history from a Christian faith perspective, this book is absolutely for you. Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Florentin, and in this video, I want to do a quick review of this great book I got from Lifeway. The title is American History. It is a combined edition, which means there's two volumes in one, and the time span is from 1492 until the present. The author is Thomas S. Kidd, that's K-I-D-D, and it's the same. I got this from Lifeway, the same company that sent me the Tony Evans Study Bible that I made a few videos about. I'll place some links about this product at the bottom, as well as the video, so you can watch them if you want. So thank you, Lifeway, for sending this out. This is a $90 book, so it's not cheap. It's very high quality paper, full color photos all over the place, and documents, and the quality of the paper is really very nice and shiny. Great maps. So the presentation is amazing. Let me just read a few words about the author from the back cover. Thomas S. Kidd is Distinguished Professor of History, James Vardaman Endowed Professor of History, and Associate Director, Institute for Studies of Religion at Baylor University. He also serves as Distinguished Visiting Professor of Church History at Midwestern Baptist Theological Seminary. Hey, I'm a student there. I'm a doctorate student at Midwestern Baptist Theological Seminary, and I think I should try and meet this gentleman. I'm really excited to hold his book in my hand. So that's pretty awesome. Just a few words from the back cover about the book itself. In this combined edition of American History by Thomas S. Kidd, volumes 1 and 2 are presented in a single accessible source. This sweeping narrative spans the full scope of American history, from the first Native American societies to the political and cultural struggles of contemporary times. In clear, readable prose, and with attention to well-known and more obscure figures from American history, Kidd gives a robust account of the events, people, and ideas that shaped our nation. Students will come away from American history well-informed and better prepared to wrestle with the political and cultural changes that have dramatically transformed contemporary American life. So the book has some 650 pages, two volumes in there, and just a brief review of the chapters maybe, or the sections. There are 30 chapters altogether. Chapter 1 is titled Early American Encounters, and chapter 30 is titled The Age of Terrorism. There's an introduction as well as illustration credits and an index, a full index at the end. Let me just pick a random section from the book maybe and read for you. I already read a short paragraph in my previous video when I got my new glasses, and I don't have them here now, so I have to read without them. But I'm on page 343, and the section is titled Big Business and the American Economy. I'll just read maybe one paragraph. The new business titans such as J.P. Morgan in banking, Andrew Carnegie in steel, and John D. Rockefeller in oil revolutionized and exercised unprecedented dominance in their fields. The previous section was about Billy Sunday, so there's a picture of him there. Pretty funny. So I cannot wait to read through this. Now, I'm probably not going to read page by page. I'm probably going to go to different periods in history that I have interest in. I'd like to look at maybe, the 1700s and 1800s, when we have the rise of the, you know, the Wesleyan movement and the Great Awakening. I'd be very curious to learn about that from an author like Thomas Kidd. And I wonder if there's any sections specifically dedicated to that. For example, chapter 13, The Civil War Begins. That would be a great section to read. The Age of Andrew Jackson. Let's see. World War II. Looks really interesting. I would just like to find some periods where there were also major religion, Christianity developments. Like the 1800s, maybe. Maybe some periods during the Renaissance, since this does begin in the 1400s. Let me find another random section to read for you. How about, let's see, page 179. I think this is close to what I was reading in the other video, so the author is probably still talking about slavery. So page 179, the section is called A Reforming Age. I'll just read a couple of sentences. Anti-slavery was only a small part of a much larger movement in the antebellum era to bring about moral reform inspired by evangelical Christian ideals. One of the first campaigns, the modern missionary movement, was illustrated by the work of Samuel Worcester and other among the Cherokee Indians. Although evangelical Christian missions to Native Americans and others began earlier, many date the beginning of America's international missions movement to the Haystack Prayer Meeting, of Christian students at Williams College in Massachusetts in 1806. The students discussed and prayed for the spiritual needs of people in faraway lands such as India and China. I like that section. It's just every time I read about that sort of thing, I feel that the Christian church did not do enough back then, and possibly even today doesn't do enough to, but especially back then, enough to make sure that nobody would be a slave and nobody would be treated as property. So it's possible that, I'm excited to read that section there. I just wish that they did a lot more and a lot sooner. And I think it took too long for the Christian church to stand up to the ridiculous idea of slavery. But it is good to read that there were at least isolated efforts to do that. So it troubles me to read about that sort of thing. Let's read something different. Oh, here's a picture of a, I'm assuming, a boxing champion. Maybe not as depressing. Let's see. This is John L. Sullivan. He was the champion of the world. He was born, I'm assuming, boxing. Advertising and media coverage also transformed boxing into a popular commercial enterprise. Irish immigrant and editor Richard Kyle Fox was not a boxer himself, but the National Police Gazette, his sensationalist paper, helped make boxing among the most covered and discussed sports of the late 19th century. Then moving on to talk about the gentleman in the picture, the boxer John L. Sullivan, another child of Irish immigrants, was arguably the most famous sports celebrity of the era. Early in his career, Sullivan sometimes still participated in marathon, bloody, bare-knuckle fights, but his most famous clash came in 1892 against gentleman Jim Corbett. In a gloved bout, they competed for a stunning $50,000 prize before 10,000 spectators at a New Orleans arena. Corbett shocked the nation by defeating the Boston boy, Sullivan. I remember seeing this picture before, but I didn't know the name or the history behind it. So, great variety of information in here. Some of the later pages, I mean, I'm not into politics, actually. I cannot stand politics. I mean, I like the way the government works, but I don't, very much like the people running it. I'm not into politicians at all. So, but anyways, the last few pages, I do see pictures of presidents and mentions of presidents and elections and disputes and debates and things like that. The big section on September 11, that should be an interesting topic to look at. But anyways, yeah, great variety in this book. Information about astronauts and space exploration. Here's a cool picture I haven't seen before. So it looks like the book has a very wide scope and covers a great variety of topics throughout the history that it covers. And I think the way that I'm going to read this, because I'm not a historian, but I do love history, is I'm going to pick one section at a time that interests me, and I'll read that. I think I'll start with, like I said, the 1800s and try to find some connections with the Puritans, the Wakers movement, the Wesleyan movement, you know, the Great Awakening. So maybe 1700s, 1800s, somewhere around there, and then find some connections in this book about that. Awesome book. I was going to read it and offer it here for somebody who needs it, but my son is a soon-to-be high school history teacher, so he's probably going to take this from me very soon. So I won't offer this to anybody, because it'll go probably in his library. But I'll enjoy reading some of the sections, I'm sure. Anyways, wanted to do a quick review of this book. I saw this on sale on Amazon right now. The price is $90. I think I saw it for $64 for two volumes. This is an academic book, so as you know, academic books are not cheap. So I highly recommend it for your own personal study, or if you're a student of history, or a Christian student of history, this book might be a really good choice for you. Take a look at it. I'll place links at the bottom, a couple Amazon links for you to look at. I'll also place the link for the Tony Evans Study Bible here, so you can take a look at that. Thanks for watching my video. If you have any questions or comments, write them at the bottom. Please give this video a thumbs up when you get a chance. That's going to help with the algorithm. Also, if you're not subscribed to my channel, please take a moment to do that. Click that bell too. Thank you so much for that. Let's have a sip of tea here. Really good. Have a nice day. Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.